Today, you tune into the temple, episode 7. Don't forget, guys, you should tell your friends about this. Tell them to listen on YouTube. You just punch in Dr.Sparman, the temple, and Google. And you'll follow a series of episodes. Not every day you see a heart surgeon or an interventional cardiologist talking about scripture and religion. But I must say, it took me a long time to get here. A lot of facts going in and delving down into facts. Reading a lot of articles by famous scientists. Delving down to prove a lot of stuff. It took me a very long time to get here. But I'm here. And what makes the difference between this episodes and episodes and program the temple from others is that I'm not only showing you what the word says, I make reference to scientific facts that we scientists rely on. So, if you are a believer, if you are an atheist, if you are an unbeliever, but have some serious questions, this program is for you. And for you who's sitting there with no interest in what's going on around you, it's for you too. Because I can tell you something right now. Everybody, every human being wants to know something. You know what they want to know? The truth. Remember, the master said once, the truth shall set you free. When you're set free, you shall be set free indeed. But the truth, that's what we want to know. Today, maybe episode 8 and 9, it'll take me a while to get the whole thing together. Guy by the name of Eric Metaxas, he's an author, American author, and he wrote a lot of books. He wrote an article actually at the New York Times. And his article was interesting. He said science increasingly makes the case for God truthful. He said also, science can never prove or disapprove the existence of God. Seven billion people in this world, and every one of us want to know the truth. Why do you think there are so many religions? They're in search of the truth. Why? Why am I here? What's going on? Me, small me, and you got something called the Milky Way? Where you have millions and billions of galaxies and solar systems? We just dealing with our solar system right here, you know. We got the sun, and we got 9 planets. Well, supposedly, Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Uranus, Pluto. No, Pluto was involved in there. Neptune, but they've changed the classification of a planet. And Pluto was so small that a mass did not meet the criteria. So it was removed. So now there are 8 planets in our solar system. We on Earth. What about the other 7? What's going on? Don't you worry about, don't you wonder about these things? Everybody wanna know. It's an interesting topic. Some people may believe that they don't care, but everybody wanna know the truth. And I'm gonna try to help you by making reference to what we know so far. Remember at one time, people used to believe years ago, people believed that if you walk too far on the earth, you'll fall off, because it's flat. And that was the golden rule. You see, I got a problem with when people come and give you information, especially if it's information that is a little, it's interesting because it may have some taste in it, answer some questions, and give people all kind of perception. But when it's disproven, or when it was and it's outlawed, nobody come and nobody, that's not interesting anymore. Bad news is so gullible and appetizing. Yes, you people right now, with the internet we have going on right now, oh, the world is right now at your fingertips. John Delancey can just go and type in, and he just suddenly become a scientist. And he can type stuff in, and the whole world see it. It wasn't like that before. People are disguising in all formats and sending out bad information out there. Nice. When they send a good thing out there, nobody has interest. You see all of these scientists making all that type of discovery, whether it's Darwin, Aristotle, I don't care, Newton, name any one of them, Archimedes, name them. You think everything they thought about was right? No. They made mistakes. They made a foundation for other scientists to build on. But nobody come back and say, hey, it was proven that it was incorrect. That's not interesting. News, all the news media, they have no interest at all in getting that out there. They'll tell you the facts that you want, but when it's disproven, they wouldn't tell you. Huh, that's the world we're living in. Guys preaching over there, thousands of people are being healed. Who cares? Another guy going with gun over there and started to shoot 300 people. Hey, that's news everywhere. That's how we have developed. That's where society is going. That's where news and all that stuff is going. But the truth you want to know, let's go to the scripture and see what the scripture has to say. Genesis chapter 1, when everything began. You may have heard actually in my previous episodes I spoke about our existence on this earth, 6,000 years or thereabout. But science would have it that the earth is 4.54 billion years old, or 4 billion, some people say 100 million, some people say 50 million. Scientists, they vary in the way, the summation. But the scripture, let's read what it has to say. So Genesis chapter 1, verse 7. After God made lights and said that there be light and all of those, I wouldn't go into that. And God made the firmament, or the sky. That's verse 7. And divided the waters which were under the firmament from the waters which are above the firmament. And it was so. So what we see right now is a big bubble of water. Big bubble of water. Top and below. Everything is in there. The Milky Way, the solar system, the stars, the sun, everything is in there. And God called the firmament heaven, and the evening and the morning were the second day. He'll go on to tell you later on how God allowed below the firmament, which is the sky, allow the land to separate underwater. Interesting, isn't it? And then the sky above, it's called heaven. Oh. So if you're in heaven, it means that gravity has no hold in you. You're on earth, gravity grab you. But if you stay and you're right above in the sky or in heaven, then gravity does not have a force on you. Remember, I talked about the guys walking off. Older scientists used to feel it was flat. But when you go on the outside and you look, really, it's a sphere, it's a circle or a sphere. So it means that we are landing, if you're in Poland, or you're in the Caribbean, or if you're in the United States, or if you're in the UK, or if you're all the way down to the end there, somewhere in South America, you find that you're in different portions of on this, but to you, because of the distance and how massive the earth is, it's flat for you, right? So we're going all the way around. Right now, I'm talking to you from the outside, someone looking. I could be head down talking to you like this. Why not? That's why sometimes when it's night here, it's day on the other side. So I could be right now, the earth is, you have the revolution and the rotation. So you different points, different periods, we're in different positions. So I can be upside down right now talking to you. So it's not flat, we found out, the sphere. And in this sphere, you got water, various seas and oceans. Land, that's what he did. Interesting, isn't it? Interesting. Let's go on a little bit further. Remember I said that everybody wants truth. Everybody's looking for it. Children, adults, and the elderly. The book of John, chapter 18. Verses 37 and 38. They brought Jesus before Pilate. Pilate therefore said unto him, Art thou a king then? Jesus answered, Thou sayest that I am a king. To this end was I born, and for this cause came I into the world, that I should bear witness unto the truth, and everyone that is of the truth heareth my voice. The truth. We all want it. Now, what is truth? We have life on earth. You ever wonder why people never went, or the astronauts, they never went to Mercury, which is the smallest planet. Now it used to be Pluto, but Pluto's been removed, as I said earlier. Mercury, too hot, too close to the sun. Venus, they didn't touch that. Too close. Aircraft can't land there. Mars, yeah, they went there. Rocks and gully and dust and stone. No sign of life. You go further down, probably Neptune, so far away from the sun, freeze cold. Man or men always want to know if there were intelligent life in any one of these planets. Extraterrestrial type of activity going on. Always want to know that stuff. Trying to find that. You hear every now and then people talk about seeing some object, the pilots. What's going on? You need this whole system of living. So complex. Even our bodies, this body, as a surgeon, I can tell you, this body is a complex setup. How could you keep your composition of your blood in such a way that it causes you to maintain homeostasis? And every day, your sodium, potassium, chloride, calcium, magnesium, still right range is a complex thing. You hear all these theories, evolution, Big Bang Theory, all of that you're going to hear on the temple. We'll talk about them. This temple going to tell you about all these scientific thoughts, and I'm going to dissect them for you. Now, what do you need for life to exist? I'll read them out to you. You must have the right ingredients in any planet. To sustain life. Here on earth. You see the other planets? They've got their purpose, you know. They do. You ever thought that the other planets and all of those things in our solar system, and even the Milky Way, is done, it was set up in such a way to make the right formula for us? You heard about Jupiter. Do you know what's the function and the purpose of Jupiter? Jupiter has a gravitational force so strong, that it attracts any piece of material or masses that can come and destroy this Earth. Asteroids? That circles like that, then they come out of circuit, they come on this Earth, cause a real destruction it can cause. Probably we wouldn't have been here. So the gravitational force is so strong on Jupiter that all of the asteroids and so forth that escape and all the objects, they're drawn into Jupiter like a scavenger to preserve this Earth for us. That's crazy. And we are so geographically situated that the heat from the sun is right to sustain life. Watch. So we're in the right one, the right distance from the sun. And the temperature we have here is conducive to living. We have the right atmospheric pressure for liquid water at our surface. Remember, you can't live without water, no matter what the organism is. No matter what the living organism is, you need water to sustain life. There are three things you need. You need water, you need heat, and you need organic chemicals like carbon, oxygen, hydrogen, and nitrogen. Heavy metals, that's, you may have heard of the periodic table, where you have the transition elements like gold and copper, you know, and iron. Those are heavy metals that you need. You need all this composition, it's complex, to really get together and sustain life. So water needed. Without water, done. Next, we have the right ingredients. The right balance of heavy metals we talked about and organic molecules for life to arise. We have a right amount of water so that our world has both oceans and continents. Life has started in our world very early, sustained itself for over the planet's entire history, and give rise to creatures of all form. You need to have those ingredients for life. For it to happen, we men, or mankind, we're able to make life, but from life, never make life from things that are not alive. I don't care what the cloning, whatever we do, we use life to produce more life, never from inanimate objects, or objects that are not living. Only one man did that. The Heavenly Father. So, the truth of the matter is, we are here on this earth and we have all these different types of beliefs, whether it's cultural, whether it's scientific, whether it's scriptural, whether it's religious, we have all of those explanations. We gotta explain this thing. This series will continue next week, episode 8. And I'll show you, as we continue to study the scripture, to find out what is truth, why science complements God. He's the biggest scientist. To understand science, you really have to understand God. Imagine that. You imagine all of these things happening just suddenly. Boom, like that. Complex things like this. Everything had to be right. The oxygen, the carbon dioxide. You think about the trees out there. They use carbon dioxide with water to produce food. Right? And oxygen. And we take the oxygen from them and produce carbon dioxide. So look at the cycle. It's going there. Cohabitate. All of that stuff, all of that balance is happening. How could that just happen spontaneously? 21% oxygen right now. That's what we have in this earth. Put it to 18%. See what happens. We're gone. So complex. For you to believe that all this thing just happened just like that. You need to sit down. Maybe you're too close. Step back. Step back. Get the bigger picture. Next Tuesday, Eastern Standard Time. Right here on the temple. Just punch in Dr. Sparman, the temple, in Google. And follow these series that I'm here, fellowship, that I'm introducing to you. And we learn more about science and God. This is Dr. Alfred Sparman. Until next week.